Healthcare is one of the areas where I think we need a lot of public investment at this point in time if you want any kind of system to actually reach the common man. We need to actually have a national roadmap for healthcare in India so that it is affordable, accessible, and of course it's quality healthcare.
There is one institute in India where a holistic model of healthcare is being practiced. An institute that has gifted thousands of people across India normal lives with the aid of implanted medical devices. An institute that has enabled many to revel in the joy of being reborn, of being able to experience the warmth of a loved one's smile all over again, like Ramesh.
I am operation engineer.
This is where Ramesh and thousands of others received a new lease of life. The Sri Chitra Tirunal Institute for Medical Sciences and Technology, initiated in the mid-70s by the royal family of Travancore and the then Chief Minister of Kerala, Sri Achyuta Menon. It was Dr. Valyathan and a team of dedicated doctors who nurtured it. In 1981, the Parliament of India declared it an institution of national importance in order to unite medical care and technology development under a single institutional framework. This multi-pronged approach is rapidly evolving as a sustainable model for healthcare in India.
The entire journey of the institution, starting as a hospital, going on to healthcare technology development, and then focusing on public health, has been like sailing in uncharted waters. Like any voyage, it is never smooth. There are always stormy seas, and then calm sets in, because it was for the first time an institution of this kind was being set up. As a whole, we not only brought in new technologies and techniques in healthcare, but also made it affordable to the common man.
The first and the most visible arm of the institution is the hospital. The hospital focuses on neurology and cardiology tertiary care, with special emphasis on congenital heart diseases, epilepsy, Parkinson's disease, and interventional radiology. Strictly a referral hospital, once the patient is admitted, the hospital takes over, right from clothing and food to treatment. No bystanders, no special considerations, and no differentiation whatsoever between underprivileged patients who are given free treatment and privileged patients who can afford to pay. Teams of highly skilled doctors backed by the best of technology take care of every patient, providing optimal health care. To guarantee individual attention, the hospital ensures that the number of outpatients as well as inpatients who come in from across India stay well within manageable limits.
They are in a position to today perform the kind of surgical interventions that are done elsewhere in the world with the same level of success. And they're also undertaking a biomedical research in their own institution to make this healthcare system affordable to a larger number of people.
A strong telemedicine network further ensures that patients, especially in rural areas across Kerala as well as India, are offered consultation. Follow-up treatment is also possible, saving patients a lot of time and money. The institution remains very sensitive to the healthcare problems of the society. Realizing the need for a comprehensive care program for Parkinson's disease, a first of its kind, movement disorder clinic was set up in 1996. Over 2,000 patients have benefited from this program that combines drug treatment, counseling, surgery, and implantation of advanced devices like deep brain stimulators.
Epilepsy was another area where comprehensive treatment was not available in the country. Realizing this, the hospital set up an epilepsy clinic, which in a span of 10 years cured thousands of people. And better still, the model of this first of its kind epilepsy program was made available to other healthcare centers across the world to replicate.
April 6th, surgery kaiyinu. Anesthesia, ഒരു പ്രാവശ്യം പോലും അസുഖം വന്നിട്ടില്ല. ആഴ്ചയിൽ 10 പ്രാവശ്യമെങ്കിലും ഫിക്സ് വരുമായിരുന്നു ഞാൻ. ഇന്ന് ഒരു പ്രാവശ്യം പോലും അസുഖം വരാത്ത പൂർണ്ണമായിട്ടും അസുഖം ഭേദപ്പെട്ട ഒരാളാണ്.
This 239-bed hospital, a self-contained environment in every way, also has a state-of-the-art blood bank that caters to the requirements of the hospital as well as provides blood and blood components to other hospitals on request. Renowned globally, the institution treats over 90,000 patients every year, in the process performing over 3,000 major surgical procedures, many of them involving the replacement or implant of medical devices like heart valves. What sets the institution apart is the fact that the development of these indigenous heart valves and a range of other life-saving and life-enhancing technology is done in-house. It is here, in this serene green campus, that the research and development arm of the institution functions. This R&D wing has developed many medical devices that were hitherto being imported. Devices like mechanical heart valves, hydrocephalus shunts, blood bags, oxygenators, orthopedic and dental restoratives, to name a few. The best part is that the patent to commercialization rate here is 35%, thanks to the simple fact that research here is need-based, with a clear focus on ensuring that the results reach patients as early as possible. Once the requirement for a specific medical device is identified, the team here starts product research and initiates work on identifying appropriate biocompatible materials that are essential for the device. This requires innovative research, something that the institute has the expertise as well as state-of-the-art technology to carry out. Once the device has been designed and prototyped, an array of tests are initiated to examine how well it will integrate with the biological system. For the same, the device is sent to the preclinical laboratory for evaluation, and from there to process development and pilot production. Then begins the preclinical animal evaluation. Once the ethical committee approves the readiness of the device for use in patients, clinical evaluation starts in the hospital, and then the successful technology is transferred to the industry for scaling up and commercialization. The fact that the institution has the renowned international COFRAC accreditation goes a long way to lend credibility to the device in international markets.
Today, standards are becoming applicable all over the world, including India, that you need this certification. And the institute is the only internationally recognized testing center, not only in India, but I think probably in South and South Asia.
We went through a very rigorous review of the products, and we found that the products developed were at par excellence. They were the products that were matching international standards. The kind of research that is going on in India, there are a lot of cutting corners, but Sri Chitra has gone through, done a very thorough research and very thorough test of the products.
It's a matter of pride that the TTK Chitra heart valve is exported to Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, South Africa and Malaysia. This has come to a reality that the Indian heart valve sells for about one-third the price of imported heart valves, yet having the same quality as any other valve made elsewhere in the world.
Interestingly, the institute also functions as an incubation center for select industrial partners who want to produce medical devices and market them.
This first-of-its-kind R&D center in India has won many awards, including the prestigious National Technology Award for the artificial heart valve.
What delights us most is the fact that international level technologies are available to the common man at affordable prices. Our efforts can play a key role in achieving India's target of meeting 50% of its market demand by the year 2020. The best part today is that increasingly even private industries are investing in this area of research spurred on by our successes. But what the country needs today is for passionate youngsters to venture into this area of demanding R&D.
Understanding the need for quality manpower and a well-functioning public health system, the institute set up the Achyuta Menon Center for Health Science Studies. Dedicated to training healthcare professionals in service, research and the formulation as well as implementation of health policies, the institution as a university offers a Master of Public Health program in addition to DM and MCH degrees in medical specialities, diplomas in advanced nursing and technology, and PhD in several science and technology disciplines. The faculty here also provides consultancy services to various international and national organizations, including the Government of India and various state governments. The Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, has recognized this as a center of excellence for public health training and has also started sponsoring candidates for the master's program under the WHO Fellowship. Many specialized projects and research programs are underway, many of them with financial assistance from international foundations like MacArthur, Rockefeller, and Ford.
The entrance test here is very transparent, and the program is designed to be very holistic in terms of learning. One which combines classroom sessions, hospital stints, research, exposure to technology innovations, interfacing with industry experts, and so on. It's a great place to be at.
The field-based research work done by the center has brought many health-related social issues to light. The Perambilav project near Guruvayur and Athyanur Sri Chitra Action ASA are classic examples of the initiative of this center. In Athyanur, a village on the outskirts of Thiruvananthapuram, a comprehensive geo-reference health mapping was done in order to enable disease forecasting, and this was backed by outreach programs in association with the hospital to ensure that quality healthcare percolates down to the grassroots level.
I would like Sri Chitra Institute to be a model for high quality, affordable patient care, particularly for people with poor socioeconomic backgrounds.
With every passing day, the synergy achieved by the three-pronged strategy, super speciality patient care, technology innovation, and human resource development, is taking the institution from strength to strength, creating healthcare management models others can replicate. And more importantly, enabling society directly as well as indirectly to lead healthy and happy lives.